All right, we're all ready? Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here today. My name is Shannon Martin. I am the MLA for Morris, and more importantly, I am the representative for this area, Headingley, which is one of the fastest growing areas here in the province of Manitoba, both economically and residentially. First, I would like to welcome our special guests, Provincial Minister of Infrastructure, Ron Schuler, and Federal Member of Parliament for Charleswood, St. James, Assiniboia, Honorable Doug Eiffelson. I'd also like to welcome Headingley Mayor John Mouseth, as well as councillors and other municipal officials who have joined us today. Manitoba's highways are an important investment and asset here in our province, and investments in projects reinforce our shared commitments to economic growth. I would now like to invite the Honorable Ron Schuler to speak on behalf of the province. Mr. Schuler.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and first of all, to all of you, our apologies in starting late today, and Minister Jordan will not be joining us right now. She is somewhere in the air trying to get here. Evidently, Toronto's having a weather event, and for any of us who have flown lately, you know how tough those can be and how aggravating it is, and you know, we wish her a safe flight, and perhaps we can meet up with her if not later on today, then tomorrow. So we did want to proceed with this great announcement. And ladies and gentlemen, if there's one thing we know as Manitobans, and that is that 80% or more of what we produce, we have to sell to others. We do not consume more than 20% of what we produce. So we produce a lot of good stuff that needs to get to market. And we need good roads to do that. So our roads and our highways don't just connect us as Manitobans, which is important. It also connects Manitobans to the rest of the world. And it gets our product to market. And the other thing that we know, and I was going to tell a federal minister who may not know this, we have something called gumbo. And for those of you who in younger years put on a pair of rubber boots and ran into the field and realized afterwards you had like 4 inches of mud at the bottom of your boots, our gumbo is great for growing crops, really complicated and tough to put roads on top of. So we're always repairing and we're always trying to maintain and keep up our roads. Also, that gumbo is the reason why we produce so much for the rest of the world to consume. And I always say we are blessed as a province and so is the world, because somewhere tonight a little child will go to bed with a little something in their stomach because of the 80% of what we produce we don't consume. We get to share it with the world. So it's a real blessing, the gumbo, but on the other hand, it's a little bit of a problem on our roads and our highways. So today is a great announcement. And I'm so pleased that you're here, a Member of Parliament Allison. We do a lot of these together and really appreciate doing this event together. So today is a great announcement, and it is a joint announcement between the federal government, the government of Canada, and the province of Manitoba, and that we are going to be investing an additional $291 million jointly between our two governments. And that's a really good news story. In fact, I think we should bring it down to something a little bit more understandable. I had indicated to our department we could have actually done the announcement out on the street where we're going to twin right from in front of this building past the weigh scales, and we're going to twin that section of this road. And any of us who've driven it know that that's a really good idea, and we're really pleased to have a lot of representatives, Mr. Mayor from Headingley, and you and your council. I know how pleased you are for that announcement, and there are a lot of really good projects. So we're really pleased to be here, really pleased to make this announcement, and again, it shows how well that we do work with our federal counterparts. This is a good news announcement, and Manitoba Infrastructure and the province of Manitoba look forward to getting going on these important infrastructure projects. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'll leave it at that, and back over to the MC, and I know my federal counterpart has a few things to say. So thank you very much.
I'd now like to invite Doug Eiffelson, Member of Parliament for Charleswood, St. James, Assiniboia, Headingley, to the podium to share some comments from the federal government.
Great, thank you. Well, it's good to be in particularly here in Headingley. My beginnings are here. I'm actually from here. My first home, a lot of people don't know this, was actually the RCMP detachment right over here. That was my home until I was five. No, I wasn't really a bad boy. But this has been a part of my life. And one of the things we knew of, because, I was first learned to drive a bicycle here at the age of five, and knew, was taught by my parents that, never to go near this highway, because it's a very, very dangerous piece of highway. And a lot of people have been saying, to this day, it's a dangerous piece of highway. And I remember meeting with Headingley Municipal Council 2 years ago, or three, saying that this is one of the priorities we wanted was the upgrades to this section of the highway. And for a number of reasons, but this in particular, I'm honored to be part of this announcement today. So I'd like to welcome you all to Treaty One land and Treaty One territory and homeland of the Métis Nation. And I'm pleased to be here for today's announcement, which will make a real difference to the families and businesses of Manitoba. As Minister Schuler said, the weather out east has caused Minister Jordan to not be able to make it here. But she'll be in Manitoba later today for some other announcements. So as you know, solid modern infrastructure is vital to building strong communities and improving people's quality of life. It connects us, creates jobs, protects the environment, and boosts the trade and the economy. So this is why the Government of Canada is making unprecedented investments in infrastructure projects across Manitoba. Over the last 2 years alone, we've invested in 160 projects throughout the province. That means highways, bridges, streets, transit systems, water and wastewater projects, energy upgrades, recreational facilities, and more. This work is creating good jobs for today while building a stronger economy and supporting community development for years to come. These investments are not just about fixing pipes, roads, or potholes. They're a down payment on our long-term prosperity and a future where all Canadians can thrive. Today, the governments of Manitoba and Canada are making further investments in our province's infrastructure. As this was to be Minister Jordan's first item of business in Manitoba as the Minister of Rural Economic Development, I'm very happy to be here in my home. A key part of Minister Jordan's mandate as minister is to develop a rural economic development strategy. Rural Canada is a key driver of our economic prosperity, but we know that certain barriers exist that make it hard for their communities to reach their full potential. Our plan will help address these challenges so Canadians across the country can thrive economically, enjoy a high quality of life, and be in a position to attract new businesses and residents. So the first step in developing this strategy is to meet with the communities we serve. Our government is here to listen to the concerns of rural Manitobans and learn firsthand what priorities we should focus on to enrich their lives and encourage community development. So in short, we'll find ways not only to meet, but exceed the needs of rural Canada and make these communities vibrant places where people want to do business and to put down roots. And there's no better way than to make an important announcement that will greatly benefit Manitoba's rural communities, especially the businesses that rely on the highway system to move their goods and to customers. So I'm very pleased today that we'll be contributing over $143 million to 8 projects that will significantly improve Manitoba's transportation corridors. Approximately 350 kilometers of road will be improved through these projects, including repaving work on highways 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, and 16, and a number of intersection upgrades. New lanes will also be added along Highway 6 and along Highway 75 to improve connections to the U.S. border. From Reynolds to St. Anne, where so many visitors travel the Trans-Canada Highway as they enter Manitoba from the east, to the southern stretch of Highway 75, where Manitoba's businesses move their goods across the U.S. border, to right here in Headingley, where many of my constituents in our community rely on Highway 1 to commute to the city and back home again at the end of the day. This work will help create a safe, smooth transportation network and promote economic growth for years to come. Infrastructure investments like these play a large role in improving the quality of life in rural communities, And in Manitoba so far, we have provided more than $815 million through our historic $180 billion 12-year infrastructure plan. This is going towards 188 projects that are creating jobs, boosting economies, and strengthening the middle class. This includes more than $6.5 million in funding announced earlier today for five important water and wastewater projects in some of Manitoba's smaller communities, upgrades to Brandon's transit system, and the purchase of five new accessible transit vans for people with reduced mobility in Selkirk, Morden, and Morris. By investing in the infrastructure that communities need, the Government of Canada is helping everyone contribute and share in our nation's prosperity. And this is how we create a bright future for all Canadians, and we look forward to building it with you. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Schuler and Mr. Eiffelson. This concludes our formal program for the afternoon. For assembled media, there will be a photo opportunity momentarily, followed by an opportunity for a question and answer directly with either the minister or the member of parliament. So again, thank you very much. And again, a special thank you to my friends and colleagues at the RM of Headingley. So thank you.